This episode of Computer Club Lesson was recorded on April the 3rd, 2017. This week we talk all about Thunderbird mail. Hello, welcome to Computer Club Lesson. This episode is brought to you by the Binary Guys.
Yeah, but yours is crazy.
Yes, it is.
It's so small.
Okay, it's 1 o'clock again, folks, and time to start. Today, we're going to make sort of a deepish dive into Mozilla Thunderbird Mail. James is going to show you how to load it, and then I will show you how to configure it, and we'll take questions on it. We talked about this before the class, that there are some questions about Thunderbird Mail. And because I am now recommending Thunderbird Mail over any Microsoft product, if you're on the web, you're fine, but using a local email client like Outlook or any of the others, Microsoft is not doing a very good job of keeping these systems up to date and working properly.
So the Windows mail doesn't work well?
Windows Live Mail is not working very well with your local email client provider, and that's really Source Rogers. Okay, and a lot of people in the village are having nothing but grief with it. So I am now recommending Mozilla Thunderbird Mail as an email client. With that, James is going to show you how and where to download it. And tag James, you're up.
Okay, can I do it from here? I'm sleepy. All right. So. Before we begin installing it, we have to find it. And I'm just going to open up Google Chrome. And to find it is just as simple as putting in Thunderbird. Yeah, because we already looked at it. Thunderbird Mail. And you want to go to www.mozilla.org. It's typically the top one. And from here, you can just hit free download. And Chrome will ask you where to put it. Typically, it will put it in the downloads folder. But we're going to put it in on the desktop.
Your computer's so slow.
What did you press to hit desktop? What icon did you press to hit desktop?
Once that file window opens, you can move the file window around with its bars. Sometimes you'll find the desktop is way up the top and you'll see it right away, so you have to move the bars around. To find it. That's why you may not see it, because it's at the very top.
Are you trying again?
No, it finished installing. I just need to find it in here. There it is. All right. So here it is, Thunderbird. We'll just run that.
So it automatically puts the icon for you.
No, that's James just downloaded. The file to the desktop, so you can find it right away. In your case, it will download to the downloads folder.
Yeah.
It will be in there.
Which, just for a quick thing, downloads folder can be found by your user inside your user file. It'll just be whatever your user file is named. And then it's just right here, downloads. And that's how you would find that.
So if you clicked on downloads,
it would be in there. If I
Thunderbird?
Huh? It would be named
under
Thunderbird.
Mozilla.
Mozilla, okay.
So I run the program, so we're gonna hit next. We're gonna do a standard installation, and down here we'll make it so it's the default mail application. And it's going to install, show you where it's going to install.
You don't change that, you just let it install where it plans to.
Yeah, unless you have multiple hard drives, it's just best to let it install where it wants to.
Okay.
Because if you have multiple ones, like if I had a terabyte hard drive connected to this, I want it to go in there.
Okay.
Then you would have to say, yeah, I want it to install in here. But other than that, you don't have to. So it's finished installation. So we're just going to hit finish, and it should launch it automatically.
Okay, now I would want to keep mine, the default one is Hotmail. Just uncheck that box.
Well,
yeah, you can uncheck it. Now when you say Hotmail, what you're really talking about is going to a web page. You open a web page in Outlook.com.
Okay, I believe you. what happens is, of course, I read MSN, the news, that's my home page, and then at the top it says Outlook, and when I click on that, I get Hotmail.
Yes, okay, now, what you're talking about here and what James is talking about here don't have any relationship to one another.
Oh.
We are putting a local email client on your computer. And it's called Mozilla. And if there are any other local email clients, like Windows Live Mail, or Eudora, or anything like that, Mozilla becomes the default email client, right? But Outlook.com is not an email client. It's a web page.
So I still just click on Outlook to look at that.
Exactly so.
Well, how would I get to that then?
We'll come to that.
Okay, I can wait.
I don't know.
So, it's now fully awake. And we want to create a new account, so I'm going to hit email.
They still have newsgrams? I just saw newsgrams in there. I haven't seen those in years.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, you can make a new email address who are sponsoring Thunderbird from Gandhi.net. Gandhi! What's he doing here?
I don't want you to take it much further, James, because I'll be putting my own email address in there.
So we don't need anything to do with Gandhi?
No.
No. What you would do at the bottom is just hit skip this and use my existing email. Yes. So you can use like your Rogers source or in our cases Gmail.
So this is what you would use with the email address you were given when you had got your source cable.
Exactly so.
So we have a different email address on Hotmail or Gmail.
Okay, you can use them. Okay, now James has got to this point, downloaded and installed. I'm going to take over here.
Okay, you did ask the questions after, right?
Okay.
Sorry.
Go have a look and see how that computer's doing, James.
I need to ask as it goes off again.
Yeah.
Well,
that's the
side.
Okay. At this point, as Dale said, you want to put in your email account for Source or Rogers, whatever it is, or if you have another kind of email account from Gmail or Hotmail or Outlook or any of those web providers, you can also use this for that. Okay?
Can I put a new one in?
You can put a new email
account into here. If you make it on the web first and get all of the information about your account ready to put in this local email client. Now I'm going to say this one more time because there seems to be a little bit of confusion. When I say local email client, what I'm talking about is a program that runs on your computer right here.
And nobody else's.
And nobody else's, just this. When we talk about webmail, you can go to any computer on the planet and log into your webmail from any place in the world. Okay? If you don't have this computer with you, and the only place you have mail is on a local client, you're not doing mail. Okay? So when I say local client, when James says local client, we are talking about the computer right in front of you. And it's local. When we're talking about webmail, we're talking about internet email servers, which you log into like Gmail, like Outlook.
How okay. do you know the difference? How would I find out the difference?
When you say the difference,
I mean, which is a web? How would I know which
okay.
is a web and which is
a yeah. local? As a matter of fact, just about every email provider that you can name has email available on the web. Like Source, you can log into your Source account, okay, from a web page. And then you are looking at your email on the web. When we say local account, we mean that the mail downloads to your computer. It is collected up from Source cable, downloads to your computer, and is removed from the Source cable mail server. Okay? The mail server at Source cable says, okay, you got your mail. You can't see it here anymore unless you tell it, leave it here for 5 days or 10 days or whatever. Okay? So, what we want to do in this case is we want to create a new account for email. And here again, we just opened this up and it wants you to open a Gandy.net. We're not going to do that. We're going to think, we'll configure it later.
It's going to be the one beside it, actually. We'll skip this and use my existing email.
Yes, exactly. Okay. So it brings up this window and it's gone into the computer and found out my name, so it put it there. If the name is wrong, you can change it. Then it says, what's your email address? Well, I'm going to use a webmail address, but it's also a local email address. I'm going to use from bill.net, so it's BSWILLIA at bill.net. Okay, and I'm going to put in a password for this. Now, with any kind of luck at all, and I've also clicked on remember my password, with any kind of luck at all, Thunderbird Mail is really good at this. It understands a whole bunch of different email types of Gmail, Outlook, your local server like Source or Rogers. It understands all of these things. And it will, once you have done this, given it your name and or your email address and your password, it will go and just automatically configure Thunderbird Mail to make it work. So it's looking up all of this stuff. Okay, and it found it.
So we don't have to know the IMAP and the PUF. it decides.
In the case of Rogers source cable, you would want to go with POP because their email server is POP mail. Okay, so you would just click over to POP. But in this case of Bell.net, it knows that I can make remote folders in IMAP because it is configured for IMAP. So I'm just going to tell it that we're done. If things have gone wrong, you can manually configure this. Okay, but look what it's done. It's found the SMTP of HM Simpatico. That's where the mail resides. Okay, it's found my username. It's found the right ports to enter. Okay, it's found all of this stuff. Ordinarily, years ago, you would have to put all of this stuff in by hand and you'd have to know what you were looking at. But this has just simply done it all by itself. And so we're going to click on done. Is your username and password wrong?
So does
the password?
Hmm?
The password has to be what it does. It have to be what
it has to be the same as you log in.
Originally, what you
okay?
Yeah, let me
make it. Or just put anything in.
Yeah. Right. Yep. Okay. There it is. It found it. I put in the wrong password. Okay.
I wondered if you could just put in anything.
And so it is now given me bswillia@bell.net. Okay, that's the account. It's with the proper password, and it's all set up to go. It has an inbox. Now, if I had previously set up Bell.net on the internet and given it a whole bunch of folders, these folders would automatically download because it's IMAP. They would automatically download to Thunderbird. Thunderbird knows a lot of stuff about mail. But in this case, Bell.net for me is just a very stripped down thing. It's something I got when I got my internet from Bell. So it's a place to show you things, and that's all it is. Okay. There are, when I clicked on inbox, it gave me a welcome message from Bell, okay? And it's given me the folders that are on the IMAP draft sent, junk, and deleted, okay? There's nothing in them, I know that. Now, the next thing we want to do is we want to get our addresses into this. Now, I went through this last week, it's on the video, of how to get your addresses out of whatever you're using now, be it Gmail or Outlook or another local client here like Microsoft, and get your email addresses out of there and into a place where you can load them into Mozilla, into Thunderbird Mail. So at this point, what I want to do is I want to click on my address book, and there's nothing there, as any fool can plainly see. So we are going to go to Tools, and we're going to import an address book. The reason I can do this right now is I've already exported the addresses from the internet where I have them, or from another email client. They are sitting in a folder, or they're sitting in a program on my desktop on this computer. So I'm just going to go there and get them. Now you have to tell it what you're going to import. By the way, when it says import everything, if you have done nothing to export your addresses and your email from a Microsoft client, and I believe this works for Windows Live Mail, If you just tell it import everything, it will go and find Windows Live Mail and import it. But if it can't do that, then you're going to have to do it by hand. But in this case, we're just going to import the address book. Any other mail is on its own. Now, it's going to ask you, what kind of file did you make for these addresses when you exported them from your local program, or what did you download from the internet? What kind of file? It will do Outlook. Or no, I'm sorry, it won't do Outlook. It won't do Eudora anymore. It won't do Outlook from Microsoft, from the Microsoft suite. It won't do that anymore. It used to. It'll only do Outlook Express. And the file types that it can see and understand are listed here. All of these other types of email clients locally are capable of making a comma separated value. Oops, CSV. Comma separated value. So that's what you want to export your address book to. A comma separated value. Well, I went through this last week, but I'm just emphasizing it again. It's telling you what it's going to go look for. And in the next instance, I'm telling it to look. Oh, please. So you've got to select the file. Now, I have put that file on the desktop, and it's going to be looking for I have to tell it now to go and look for a comma separated value, CSV. And by golly, there it is, contacts.csv. It just showed up because I told it what kind of file to go looking for. And so I'm going to select that contacts, and I'm going to open it. And I'm just going to tell it next because it has a good idea of the way it wants to perform this import. There's nothing you can really do with it. Give it an OK and a finish.
At this point in the video that we did on Monday in the demonstration, things started to go a little bit wrong. As I imported the file into the address book, there was things that we just couldn't see. I know where I went wrong over the last couple of days. I've had a chance to look at it and fix it. And so at this point, we will look at how the addresses go into the address book and what changes you might have to make in the address book to bring them up. Now, as I click on Finish, the contacts in the address book show up under this blue line here. If I click on it, it will show up all the contacts, but look at what it's showing me. It's showing me just an icon of the contacts that are there. They're not correct. The problem is under this View button, under this View under the menu. If you click on that and you go down to Show Name As, you'll see that it's showing as the display name. Well, the display name does not come up as part of the file. What you have to do is either click on first name last or last name first. Let's do last name first, and that way we will have them all in alphabetical order by last name. And so if we click on them, there they go. They've just showed up in the contact list that we just imported. I will show you this again. It's under View. It's under Show Name As. What you may see first is the display name, and that will only show you icons. If you go under Show By Name, show last name first, then it will show you the names in alphabetical order starting last name first, as in Bartolozzi, Beatty, Black, and so forth down the list. At this point, we'll go back to the video and see where we need to take this a little further.
Now, Thunderbird Mail has some other little things going for it. You can put events in it, and for today, tomorrow, and 5 days hence. In other words, it's a little calendar. It will send you reminders about what you want to do and such. And I've double-clicked on it, and it will make a new event. Okay, and you can put those in. You can put them in a year ahead, but they will only show up 5 days from for the next 5 days. Excuse me. It's a little calendar function for it. Beyond that, when you open an email in Thunderbird Mail, it has all of the stuff that you're expecting to see, okay? The message list, the message body that you highlight, okay? It's going to give you all of the replies and forwards and archives to folders that you make. You can move stuff to junk and delete it, and all of that stuff.
Does it have anywhere, Bob, where if you can block an email like the old days where you could block one, you didn't want any more emails to come from that retail place or whatever? I have searched and can't find in Thunderbird. How to block somebody?
There's really nowhere you can do that.
No.
Deleting it,
that's all.
Yeah.
I wondered if there was different wording than block or whatever, but I can't see.
There isn't anything like blocking an email.
No.
If you're getting mail through a web account like Outlook or Gmail, okay, even in Source, I believe you can go into Source and tell Source that all mail from this sender should go to junk.
I used to, so I'm going to have to search.
Yeah, have a look. Yes. If that's the case, it should go to junk. You can do that with most other webmail sources, okay, like
Outlook.com
and Gmail and all of those. You can do those.
Just look at Mark for a bit. I think Mark's where it's at. You can mark it as junk. And then after a while, it just automatically sends the junk.
Yeah, okay. Well, it says here, run junk mail controls. I told it that anything from Bell, now, Bell with a no reply, is junk. So the next time something from Bell comes in with a no reply, it will go to the junk mail folder.
So run junk row of mail control.
Yeah. What you want to do is right click on the message.
Right click, yeah. Yeah, that's how I delete.
Yeah. And where do we find that?
Mark.
Under Mark.
Mark, okay.
And you can run the junk mail control under Mark. And what it's doing is it's telling the email program that this kind of message, this message from Bell with a no reply, is junk. Throw it in there. Now, you got to be careful.
I know. no, you got to be on the C, like with me, the Sears one, be right on that email.
Yeah, yeah. The other thing you have to be careful of, and I've run into this problem with James, and we've talked about it, is that James sends me money from his bank, and it's coming from a no reply.
Oh.
And where does it go? It goes to the trash. And I have tried and tried and tried to get it to go to the inbox right away from TD Bank, no reply. Won't do it.
Does it? No reply. So if Mel sends you something that you have to read and answer, it will go to regular mail?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
See, like my iTunes will send me stuff, but and it's a no reply, you know.
Yeah.
Their emails are all
over. I just
say yeah. Well, it's in this case, it's from Bell.
Yeah.
Okay. So it's going to talk about Bell no reply. Bell.net no reply. That's the name that it's going to go looking for.
Yeah.
Right?
That's
right.
See. Yeah. Yeah.
Receiving email. I sent you an email.
Yeah.
Will it receive it? It has to first go through my, it's a Gmail one. I just wanted you to get some population in your thing. I wanted to see how you receive mail. Sorry, changing your process.
Okay.
The problem with this is with this Bell.net is I'm forwarding everything from Bell.net to my Gmail.
Oh, well, you'll get it later.
Yeah. So I'll get it later. I'm forwarding all mail that I get from everywhere into Gmail.
Okay.
Okay. That means that. I only have to go looking for mail in one place. I have, you know, 7 accounts, but I have it in one place.
You only have 7? You gotta step up your game.
Yeah, I know.
So essentially you're saying you don't use the local Thunderbird on your computer. You
not anymore. I just log in. Tablet, yeah.
Whatever. Okay.
Yeah, I get it on my phone, my tablet, my laptop, wherever I am in the world. If I can get to a computer that's on the internet, I can get to my mail.
So this is for people who don't want to have an internet email like Hotmail or something. They just want to open their computer, be able to do their email.
Yeah. Now, here again, I'm going to give this a try and see if it's going to work. I am going to try and make a new account here. Just for the sake of argument. I am going to tell it to do my Gmail account.
Okay.
All right. Just for the sake of argument. So it's.
But we don't want to argue.
Well, the other best thing about like it, each kind of email provider has its own pros and cons. With web, you can get it anywhere, and with local, if you have no internet, you can still look at your email. Like if internet's gone.
Oh, but you can look at your email, you just can't send any.
All right. Yeah, you just can't send it or yeah, but you can still look at it.
Yeah, I've put my Gmail address in here. And I'm going to tell it to continue, and it's looking it up, and it knows that it's IMAP. And I'm just going to tell it I'm done.
With Google, it will ask you to
sign
in to make sure, like, yo, you want this to happen?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. And so it's asking me, do I want to allow Thunderbird Mail to read my Gmail from the web? I'm going to tell it to allow. And it's done. And there is my Gmail. Okay. Now, when I click on Inbox, it just loaded all of my IMAP folders. Okay, and in the background, it is going to start populating all of these folders with mail that I've saved. Anything that I do in Thunderbird is being done on the Gmail server at exactly the same moment.
Okay.
That's what IMAP is.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay? That's what IMAP is.
What does IMAP stand for?
I'm a map.
I used to know the protocol. But
it's the mail protocol.
Yeah.
I can look it up if you like.
Okay, I'll look it up.
We may as well.
Yeah. I Google it. What is IMAP?
Google.
Internet Message Access Protocol.
Yeah, that's what that makes
I
sense.
Google everything.
Did you know there's a program you can make when someone asks you a question? There's a web page where you can just type in
the word.
What to search and send it to them, and it will automatically Google it for them.
Oh, you can actually do the Googling for a person?
Yeah. Oh. And it will just like, here you go, and we'll automatically type in the words, and it will say, Google it.
You need to show me that.
Yeah. All right, so here is the email that you sent me the other day. And did you make a reply today? No, you didn't.
I just sent that today.
Did you? Okay. Yeah. So you replied to the thing I replied to this morning.
Right.
Okay.
Oh, I didn't reply. That's a new email. I didn't even answer today's.
All right. Just me populating your email. Okay.
Don't you love people?
There you go.
You can do it now.
Yeah. So when I'm all done with this today, I'll take this home and I'll just simply make all of this stuff go away. And I'll be back to the way I was. But I'm doing this to show you that Mozilla Thunderbird Mail can do just about everything.
It's very versatile.
It is. It's extremely versatile. It knows about all kinds of different mail configurations. It does them automatically. As soon as I put in my email name and my password and clicked on done, it went out to the internet and said, how do I set up Thunderbird Mail for Gmail? And all of the information went into Thunderbird Mail and it just set it up. That simple.
Also, I wish we could say sponsored by Mozilla.
Mm-hmm. I like
talk
this,
about them so much.
Like bringing your Gmail account in here makes it the way I think email should look. I don't like the Gmail look and trying to get rid of some of the files.
Now, the other thing about Gmail, if you use Gmail, you know that Gmail has changed the way that it brings mail into the inbox. Okay, you have a primary, you have updates, you have this and that and the other thing, and people trying to sell you stuff. You've got to go through four panels to make sure you got all your mail. Well, you don't got to do that when you use Thunderbird Mail in IMAP. It brings everything to the inbox. Now, if you get a couple of hundred emails a day, that might be a huge pain in the hoo-hoo. Okay? That's why those four panels were set up in Gmail. It's trying to help you. But if you want to see everything all the time, this is the way to do it.
That's me. Outlook is just, when I open Outlook now, focused and other. Where did that come from? And
that's, they, yeah.
Focused and other.
They're trying to be helpful, Brenda.
I wish they wouldn't.
Yes, a lot of people are like that, wish that they wouldn't. Okay, it in all probability, you prefer your email like this.
A nice long line, and I can go to
nice and clear.
Yeah.
Now I have
easy.
To do all that, and then go what I was expecting. Oh, just a minute. There's somewhere. Yeah.
See,
else.
Most companies are like that one annoying person at work. That's like, I'm helping, when really they're just
getting in the way.
Just like, go over there.
Now, the other thing about IMAP Mail in Outlook and Gmail, I'm going to right-click on my inbox here, and I can make a new folder. And, you know how to do that, to make a new folder under your inbox.
Better late than never.
Better late than never. Have yourself a seat. You make a new folder under your inbox by right-clicking on it. In IMAP, when you do this, you're making that exact same folder on the internet. Boom, it's there. If I made a folder called Less Important Stuff and put it in here, As soon as I log into Gmail, I will see a folder called Less Important Stuff.
And typically all my messages will be in there.
Yeah.
I noticed too with I've got IMAP, I've got web, you know, the webmail, and I've got the local source thing.
Yeah.
I can receive emails on both of them, but I cannot send on the source one. I can't send an email. It might be my structure, I don't know. But I receive something from somebody and on source and pictures and whatever, so I wanted to send her back something. I went up to my webmail, sent the email to her, thanks, blah, blah, blah. Then when I checked the sent box, it listed it twice. Both of the email addresses
Get
the message that I sent an answer back to her.
Yeah.
It's cute because it's just, you know, it's just my structure. I can't send an email on the source thing for some reason. So I just use the
There used to be on the older version a drop down that says go and get all the mail or only get the mail from certain accounts. Huh? Get messages. There it is right there. Okay. There's a little drop down arrow. If I click on get messages, it will go out and query both.
Yeah.
Bell and Gmail. But I can click on that drop down box and I can say I only want to see email from Gmail. Okay. And the same thing when I believe when you log in, it will get messages. It will get all messages when you open Thunderbird Mail. It will automatically go and get all your messages, and then I believe when you customize this, you can tell it. No, you can't. You can't tell it much. With IMAP, as soon as a piece of mail arrives on the server at Gmail, in Mozilla it appears. You don't have to download it. It just appears.
So you don't have to do the get messages.
No, not from IMAP. From POP you do.
Okay.
From POP you have to go and get the messages. In IMAP they just appear. That's really cool.
Mm-hmm. So
okay.
Will it show you, like, if you can collapse that Gmail one?
Yeah.
Okay. So then if you have a new mail, will it have a one beside that or two showing you how many messages?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Good. Okay.
Yeah. It'll show you that there's new messages there.
I get a little thing on the bottom too that reads, it says, I get a little pop-up window at the bottom.
Yeah.
So you're using Thunderbird?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah. It tells me that I got an email. Mm-hmm.
I can't think of anything else in the write function.
It's more of a play with.
Yeah, you can, in the write function, you can write a message, you can make an event, like I just showed you over there, and you can put in a task. And these things are by calendar date. And so when you open your email, if you have a task ready for today, it'll tell you that today there's a task, tomorrow there's another task. For the next 5 days, it'll show you what is in that list. And so you don't have to forget anything.
Today you have to wake up at 8 o'clock so you can go over to your grandfather.
So let's start a new message in Thunderbird Mail. It says who I am and my email address. Now, that can be changed in the options and the tools. If I want to use BobWilya at Gmail and I want to give it the name Computer Club, I can change that. Okay, I can change that to computer club. I'm not going to do it now because it's in account settings. I'm not going to mess it up. But I can do that in account settings. I can change that so that, yes, when you get my mail, my notifications like I sent out this morning, it came from the computer club. But in fact, if you look deeply at it, it was bobwillia@gmail.com. And there's my name right there.
Okay. I get in Windows Live Mail, if I wanted to send something to the computer club, all I got to do is click on that computer club and they all go in.
Yeah.
But I can't do it on that one.
Okay.
The next thing that got messed up a little bit on the video on Monday was how to make a new list, a contact list for the address book, for the Mozilla address book. I wasn't really up to snuff on that, so we're going to show you how to make a new contact list and how it's going to work. So the first thing we want to do is click on New List, and it will allow us to make a name for the new list, and we're going to call it Computer Club. And give it an OK. And now Computer Club has gone in under Contacts. We can move all of this stuff around, but we're going to do it later. Now, if you click on Contacts, you will now be able to move a contact into this new list called Computer Club. And this is how we make a list of people that you just want to send an email to. It can be two or three, or it can be 40 or 50. Doesn't matter. So let's start here. We can do it simply by dragging, click on it, and drag the email name over to Computer Club, and you'll see that Computer Club lit up blue and the icon changed underneath the underneath the arrow. And if you just drop it, you'll see that it dropped this name into Computer Club. Let's go back to Contacts and we'll do another one. We'll do our friend Betty Ann, we'll do her, just drag it over into Computer Club. You'll see that it lights up blue. Drop it, and it's in there now under Computer Club. Okay, by the way, it's putting these in to some degree alphabetically. Let's go back to Contacts. Let's put in a bunch. You've got 40 or 50, maybe you want to be able to do a bunch. So, let's do a bunch. Let's grab let's grab this one here, and as with everything that you can do in an automated way, if you click on, or if you hold down the control key, you can select different people. If you hold down the shift key, you'll select everything from the last thing you selected, this email Ruth, and I'm going to select here to email Tish, okay, and it took those three. So we can just simply take those three and drag them over to Computer Club. When it lights, when the little panel lights up, Computer Club, it's ready to drop in, and in they go. You see they've all been dropped in there. Now then, let's send an email to all of these people. So you're in your contacts list, and you want to send an email to the Computer Club. Click on it. And click on the write button. And look what happened. All of the people that were in that contact list for Computer Club have now been put into the to line. Two. All of them. They're all in there. Okay. One, two, three, four, five. One, two, three, four, five. They're all in there. And it's just that simple. So let's do this once again. You want to send an email to your special list, the Computer Club. It can be two people. It can be 20 people. Doesn't matter. You click on the Computer Club and then click on Write. and it loads all the names from this list, Computer Club list, into an email to be sent to them. And at this point, you can also, if you don't want to see that, you can change these to BCC, so you can make them all blind carbon copies, or you can CC them. Doesn't matter. You just, the little drop-down arrow will tell you what you need to do. If you don't want that person in there, you can delete them like that. And so that's how we use the list function to make a group to send an email to.
Okay, we're just about at the end of the of our time. Any quick questions? Yes.
My screen has gone that way and I can't get it back, and I can't go up and I can't go down.
It went sideways?
It's gone to the right, so I can't use my up and down button at all. And you fixed that for me one other day, so I don't know how it got to be that. I'm working away this morning.
Oh, I think I know what you meant. You're like, instead of it being nothing but for us blue, it's like a black bar here and then blue all the way around.
Oh, I've got, let's say I'm on Globe Investor. Globe Investor comes up with the heading, but I can't move that screen.
Oh, I see what you're saying. Yes, 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 yes. I see what you're saying.
Right, I can't move it to the left. It just is.
Give it a bang to the side.
And I tried that. I tried that, but that didn't work for me.
Okay, is that what it looks like?
Mm-hmm.
Sort of?
Well, sort of. No, okay, but my...
Take this and without actually slamming it into the wall. Like, don't let your mouse slam into the wall, but have it go off screen. That's what's happening.
You're gonna move it with that.
No, I'm just gonna make the window bigger. Okay.
But
I think that's what happened.
This is what she meant.
I have got to be able to move my screen up or down, and I can't get to that.
That's what she meant.
I can't get to that.
Is that what's happening?
Pretty much all right. Like, it's not that much, but it's that idea.
Yeah, okay, all right. Yeah, what you have to do is bring your mouse cursor, this right here, to right there. Okay, up in the title bar, wherever you can get at it, in the title bar. And I'm going to bring it over there. And now I'm going to hold down the left mouse button, and that grabs it. Okay, and now I can move it.
I think I better shut the mouth. Yeah, but now what I want to do in mine is take the edge of that and move it to the left.
Then you will go down here to the bottom of the screen, and you will see that the cursor has turned into a double arrow.
Right.
Once it's done that, hold down the left mouse button and just drag it over.
Or
make the whole window big. Okay, I think that's what you really want to do, is make the whole window big.
I have tried to get out of my mind.
See, it was what's coming in, wasn't it?
What you need to do is you need to get this mouse cursor button up into the address bar of the web page, and grab a hold of it with the left mouse button and just drag it over until you can see everything. Okay, how did we make up with that?
It said it didn't work.
Yeah, it didn't work.
Well, that's what it said.
Yeah, I don't know how to test if the registry's working well. What do I do?
What on the computer did not work before we did this.
Couldn't get into Pogo games.
Okay, get her into Pogo games and let's see what happens.
Oh, we don't have internet on here. You'll have to set up the wireless.
Mm. All right. It won't work because...
The wireless won't work?
the computer probably won't pick it up.
Also, oh, yes. Yes, it will.
This computer will?
Yeah. All right. Hang on a minute. We're gonna call an end to this, folk. It's 2 o'clock. Thanks, Hope, so much for coming. I will get this up on online as quickly as I can in the next couple of days, and we'll see you in 2 weeks. 2 weeks from today.
That's Computer Club Listen for today. Thank you so much for watching. Bye-bye.